as a track cyclist.
And it's a one-off sprint, so they don't get a second chance against Ekaterina Nedenko. 12 years difference in age and plenty of world titles as well. Nine times Victoria Pendleton has won a senior world championship. Six of the nine have been in the sprint. So it just shows you how she's dominated this event. She's the reigning Olympic champion.
And she's got the weight of expectation of a nation that have enjoyed great success in the Velodrome and elsewhere in the games. And the Velodrome filling up, not quite at capacity. Every ticket has been sold in the 6,000-seater. And by the time Pendleton's going in the later rounds, it'll be absolutely jam-packed. There's Team Pendleton.
And the draw. So leading out will be Nedenko. Always a little bit more pressure on the rider that does lead out. And we know that Pendleton broke the Olympic record in the flying 200. Nice. Very impressive work there. Broke her own record she set in Beijing. Of course, Anna Mears has got the world record at 10.782.
Yeah, she's such a class act, is Victoria Pendleton. And well, she's looking forward to life after cycling. Well, I'd say she won't be cycling, but life after the intensity of competitive track cycling. And she's up against the 19-year-old Ekaterina Nedenko at the other end of her international adventure, and her time as an international cyclist, 11.649 in the heats. Nedenko nearly a second slower than Pendleton's 10.724 in the qualification rounds.
Jan van Eyden is doing a lot of work with the British team. And Victoria Pendleton, 10.724 in qualifying, against a young lady who's already medalled at world championship level in the Kieran, second to Anna Mears in Melbourne. Pendleton was hoping to do the treble, the team sprint, Kieran, and individual sprint. They were disqualified for the team sprint, which has really been the only blemish on Team Great Britain's performance of the Velodrome. And the Russian has not shown the speed that she displayed in Melbourne earlier this year, qualifying 18th in 11.699. But Pendleton's too experienced to know that she can't take her opponent lightly. Needs to be totally focused on the task ahead.
So how's the young Russian going to deal with having a legend on her wheel here? And will she try and out manoeuvre her? Well, it'll take some doing, because Pendleton's experience and her class will certainly stand her in good stead.
What she's trying to do is encourage Pendleton to take the lead. We know that the top end speed she's displayed, just blasting past opposition throughout these Olympic Games.
And opening the door, just trying to invite Pendleton through. She's a reluctant guest, so she'll stay where she is.
Little flick of the handlebars by Pendleton, forcing Nedenko down on the track. Now they roll it up. They'll get the bell lap the next time.
Winding it up at the top of the track, Pendleton. This is it. Looking for a way through down the bottom. And here we go.
Staying high, getting that run off the bank, Victoria Pendleton. Nedenko leads. They start the 200-metre sprint. Not out of the saddle yet. Diving on the inside, mistake by the Russian. Pendleton goes through. She's going to be impossible to get past from here. And Victoria Pendleton will progress and not use up an ounce more energy than she needed to.
Absolutely no problem at all. And well, that's the class of Victoria Pendleton.
What you want to do is just force her to go around you. That was the worst possible scenario for Nedenko, because at that point she had to rebuild her momentum, and then if she got onto the wheel, having to go around a rider of her class, Pendleton's class, would have been a very, very difficult assignment indeed.
11.775, and the job done. First time up for Victoria Pendleton. She can go and warm down and focus on the next round.
And Amir's against Kayona Maeda. Amir's has had a media blackout in the Olympic Village. Such has been her focus. There's Gary West, the Australian sprint coach. They share a very strong relationship tactically, and they can certainly map out a race well, but she would have been bitterly disappointed after the Kieran. Remember, only 7 months before Beijing, she had a life-threatening crash in a Kieran event in Los Angeles. Did so well to get back onto a bike and win silver in Beijing. And with that, to bronze medal in the team sprint, medal number 4 on the track at Olympic Games level for Anna Mears.
Mears is up against Kayona Maeda, the Japanese champion. Fourth in the Asian Cup, 21-year-old.
8 tenths of a second between them in qualifying. Mears second in 10.8. Maeda 17th in 11.6. You saw her, the Japanese rider, shake her helmet head after the flying 200. She wasn't happy with the time. And that's exactly why, because she's got to meet one of the higher seeds.
Yeah, Mears very focused on getting it right in the sprint. The battle with Victoria Pendleton, if and when it transpires, is going to be riveting viewing. There's no secret fact there's a great rivalry between the two. But she needs to get the early rounds sorted out. And here she goes, starting to wind it up.
So inviting for Mears to dive on the inside. I think she's got to take the invitation. But out of the saddle, and that's a good move by Maeda. Keep the tempo high. Mears comfortably is stalking at the moment. She hasn't gone for it. Now she's out of the saddle and moving up very stylishly. Maeda going 100%, and Mears just cruises up on the outside. That's a comfortable win. 11.8. Didn't expend too much energy. And that's exactly what she was looking for.
Did that really comfortably, didn't she? Just popped out the saddle on the back to get up with Maeda, and then eased around on the outside on the bend, and made it look quite easy in the end. The 28-year-old Australian is looking to go one better than a silver medal in Beijing. As I say, make up for what is a desperately disappointing performance in the Kieran. She won't want to have, I think she would be pleased that she hasn't had to do or burn herself too much in that first race. Find it comfortably done.
Well, as far as the experience go, Guo Shuang is definitely a medal contender. We saw her performance in the team sprint, driving China to be first across the line. She's in very good hands with Daniel Morlon, the former Olympic and world champion, veteran coach from France, who's now guiding the Chinese program. Guo Shuang, a former Kieran world champion. 3 medals on the track at Olympic level. It's a fine record.
Yeah, she was bronze medalist in this discipline in Beijing behind Pendleton and Mears. Well, Daniela Lariel is well, the most experienced rider in this whole event at 39. And the way they roll with Lariel, who clocked 11.569 in her qualifying, as opposed to Garshwang 11.020.
Only two riders under 10 seconds, Mears and Pendleton. But two up sprinting is tactical speed. It's not all about blasting against the clock, and that's why it can be a little bit unpredictable.
It's a reasonably good form of late, Garshwang. She won the World Cups in London and in Beijing in the sprint. Tensing up, you could see her gripping the handlebars, and now following Victoria Pendleton's maid, and now behind L'Oreal, stalking her, easing up now, and shows such power in moving past very smoothly indeed. Guashang, this is very, very good sprinting from the Chinese rider. Plenty in hand, and she clocks a time that is appreciably quicker than Pendleton and Mears as she goes in very comfortably through L'Oreal. That was good looking sprinting from the Chinese rider. She's in some form.
Confident work. Had her opponent beaten a long way out. And just to send a little message to the top two. We've got a pretty useful sprinter to come in Christina Vogel. But Laliao's been around a long time, the Venezuelan. So three of the big names get through the first test of the match sprinting. Well, Shuang in 11.371. And this is going to be a really interesting heat. Christina Vogel, of course, already Olympic champion in the team sprint. Young lady who's also had to overcome adversity. When she crashed in 2009, she collided with a minibus, almost lost her life. And did so well to get back to the World Championships the following March, finished fifth in the individual sprint. And then we know at the 2012 Worlds she won the gold medal, and backed that up with a somewhat controversial win in the team sprint. There's Virginie Quoff, European champion in the team sprint.
And 21-year-old Christina Vogel, she's clearly got a great future on the track.
Great opportunity to place her marker in the individual event, Christina Vogel, given that Victoria Pendleton has decided to retire after these Olympic Games. So the next gen will come through, and she's just about at the head of the class as far as the young riders are concerned.
How the second round, or this first round, works after the qualifying is that the fastest goes against the slowest, which is Pendleton against Nedenko, and then it continues on down. So this is Furkel, who is the fourth fastest at 11.027, up against the fourth slowest, Virginie Kueff, France, 11.439. So the racing in theory should get tighter and tighter.
Vogel has to race smartly, not get to her speed washed away by tactics from the Frenchwoman. She's trying to keep the tempo up.
The Vogel, bell will come.
Vogel's reacting, wanting to maintain the lead, and it's going to be a tough sprint for her. The youngster, Kerf's a bit of an opportunity here. Vogel in front, Virginie Kerf coming. Is she coming quick enough? She flicks the wheel on the top straight. And she's got enough guns to win, but she was made to work hard. 11.605. Not an easy sprint there for the 21-year-old.
She had to do it from the front all the way, and she was under pressure for a little moment on the first bend of the 200, but then in the end came home fairly comfortably. Just there was a moment that she had to dig deep on that back straight. But in the end, Virginie Kueff, who was seventh in the World Championship, finished well ahead of Christina Vogel, who is 14th. But Vogel goes through 11.605.
Next up we see Olga Panarina against Li Haijin of Korea. Panarina, the Belarusian world champion in the 500 time trial in Apeldoorn in the Netherlands in 2011. Second behind Annemies and the Kieran. So two bronze medals in the 500 time trial on the Kieran. She's been a good athlete at world championship level.
Well, this is a 20-year-old who's got a great future in the sport as well. She's been given the opportunity to train and live and prepare at the UCI's World Cycling Centre in Switzerland, and is starting to deliver some results. She won a small meet in Perth in March, but has been finishing in the top 10, 8th and 10th, 8th in the Beijing World Cup, 10th in Cali, 8th, 10th at the World Champs. But one would expect this her first experience, and she's certainly shown herself to be up to it.
Just under 0.4 of a second between them in qualifying. Panarina hasn't been in the sort of form she was a couple of years back at World Championship level. And the green, red and white of Belarus. Predominantly white strip of the Korean lead leading out.
And having to just keep an eye all the while, left and right shoulder. As Panarina has to find the blind spot and find that split second where she can jump.
And this is the bend. Usually if they go high, they invite the move. But Lee keeping the tempo up. Panarina has to get out of the saddle to make contact. She doesn't want to make contact too quickly. She's done it down the back straight. Now she has to back herself and she goes flat out and has got the top end speed to match. The Korean sits up, and Panarina, not knowing that, now she does, switches off, 11.608.
Well, once she got her over the top on the back straight, there was no stopping Panarina, and the Korean just didn't have, well, anything really, just backed off completely. No contest in the end. You could see the Korean really battling to get any sort of rhythm going. Realizing that the game was up, wasn't going to battle to contest the sprint. And Panarina, 11.608. Still a good time. Well, Shung clocked the fastest time of the qualifies so far, but that's all relative as to how the race unfolds and the tactics, how your opponent allows you to dictate or not, or assert your authority. Words of encouragement for Juliana Gavirendon.
She's 21 years of age against a woman who was impressive in qualifying, Sandro Guerrero Rodriguez. 11.1, qualified 6th in the red of Cuba.
11.109, that's a good result for the Cuban. Now roll off for the Cuban up front. She's 24 and the Pan American champion last year, runner up this year to Monique Sullivan. 8th in the World Championship, 6th at the World Cup in London, so she's a real contender, is Lisandra Rodriguez. She did win the Pan American Games title in March.
Of course, they've got a velodrome in the high altitude of Bogota in Colombia, where a lot of the world records have been broken. I'm sure that's the velodrome that Rendon has competed at too many times. Rodriguez, very, very watchful. Doesn't want to make a mistake, albeit she's got the sharper speed. And this is going to suit the Colombian. Rodriguez out of the saddle very early. Can Rendon stay with her? Rodriguez in front. Rendon has to go the long way around. It's going to be tough. She comes out of the sprinter's lane, but Rendon wasn't anywhere near her when that happened. And she turns off and wins quite comfortably. 11.390 is a good flying 200 under the circumstances. She did move out of the lane, but I think the Colombian at that point was beaten.
It was a really good sprint from the Cuban. She backed herself all the way, knowing that the Colombian has a good turn of speed, but new there, just perhaps drifting out across the sprinter's line, but no problem at all for the Cuban. She's a very, there we go, very composed sprinter. Knew what was needed and taking the win.
And just to remind the viewers that if you move into the sprinter's lane and then move out and hamper the progress of your opponent, you can be relegated by the officials. It's a clear rule, and that's exactly why the zone is there. There's Mark Cavendish, 23 stage wins in the Tour de France. Started his career as a scratch and points race rider on the track.
Hinting he might look at a return to the track, but only after the Olympics in 4 years' time. He has unfinished business with the Olympic Games, Mark Cavendish, you feel, after the disappointment of the road race.
There's Li Weishi, 25-year-old Asian Games gold medalist in the time trial, and of course bronze medalist in the Kieran. And Monique Sullivan of Canada, who qualified in 12th place, 11.347. This is going to be an interesting one. Can Lee bring her speed of the Kieran to the fore here? She's a better Kieran rider than she's a sprint rider at the moment. And I think on tactics, Monique Sullivan may have her covered, but not all about tactics. If you've got the speed and you can apply it in the right part of a two-up sprint, that's exactly what counts.
Well, Li Wei, she's the absolute toast of Hong Kong at the moment. She collected that bronze in the Kieran. Only the third ever medal in 17 games for Hong Kong. And carried the flag in the opening ceremony.
Of course, Lauriane Munzer was the last world-class female sprinter Canada produced, the 2004 Olympic champion, competition in which Anna Mears was placed third, so she won the bronze medal. She dives on the inside, good move that. Monique Sullivan very slow to react, so she's got the momentum. Li Weishi of Hong Kong opens up a big break. Sullivan's going to have to dig deep to produce from here. Li in front, can she keep it going? Beginning to fatigue, but the Canadian won't get there. And that's a good ride, good confident ride by Li Weishi. Sensed her opportunity, took it, and executed the move well.
Yeah, Dave, you used the word confident, and that's exactly what you could see from Li Weishi from Hong Kong. Knew she had the beating of her opponent here in Monique Sullivan, and executed very impressively, diving down. And from then on, she was in control. Monique Sullivan pulled back, but not nearly enough to get over the top of Li Weishi. So 11.300 is the time that she put down. Not that that's too relevant at all, but it is the fastest of all those so far. There she is. Now we're getting down to the last couple of heats, and these should be pretty dynamite because they are riders who've posted times very close to one another.
And Simona Krupa-Skeiter, 29-year-old, 12 global medals. She's been one of the most consistent sprinters in track cycling, against a rider 2 years her junior, Willy Cunnis, who again has been placed at sprint level behind some very good riders. Victoria Pendleton, second in the World Championships in 2009, she was, but hasn't shown that type of form at these championships. Can she produce it here?
Yeah, Willy Cunnis was 11th in Krupashaito, was 8th, 11.234, and Cunnis 11.322 in the qualifying round.
Krupashaito was second to Pendleton at this year's World Titles, when everybody thought Anna Mears would race off against the Flying Brit in the final. She was relegated. And the fact that they met in the semi-finals one of them was going to go out, either Pendleton or Mears. Just the way the seedings worked themselves out after qualifying. And Karnas, very watchful indeed. Krupashaito, both, if you took a line across their best form, that's certainly down on their premium form, both riders. So it brings the tactics so much more into play.
That is all about confidence, isn't it? If the form's not good and you've been not producing the results you've been hoping and expecting for, the confidence levels take a dip. Now, high is Krupashaito.
She's got that 500-meter time trial background, so she's going to pull this out, extend the sprint. She goes around Willy Cunnis. A strong move as Cunnis got the engines to come back. She's trying to take the tag. Now she's out of the seat. Krupashaito's in front. Not sure there's too much left in the tank. Has Cunnis got a second effort? Krupashaito will hang on. 11.528. It was a tough sprint, but tactically she got it right.
Certainly did. And Karnas trying to get over the top on that back straight, and Krupashaito showing a good turn down there, but Willy Karnas will be disappointed. He would have wanted to be a bit closer, if not getting over the top. But there's the power of Simona Krupashaito. She's got a great record, and she's looking to return to her best form. This win will give a boost of confidence ahead of the next round.
One heat to go, and this should be probably the most even on paper. Natasha Hansen of New Zealand up against Lubov Shulika. The Kiwi's already been placed and won a medal at these championships. Team's pursuit.
And Lubov Shulika, powerful and explosive sprinter from the Ukraine. She's 24. She was fourth at the World Championships and won the Astana World Cup in November last year and the European Championship. So Natasha Hansen's got her work cut out here, the New Zealander, 22-year-old from Invercargill. Works as an air traffic controller for the New Zealand Championships in February.
Shulika lost the bronze medal ride to Anna Mears in Melbourne. Hasn't brought that type of form to the boards at Stratford. It's a unique velodrome. It's produced so much excitement. So Hansen on the blue section of the track, and the commissaire is just seeing whether she drifts onto the dark blue. She can't occupy that area. Now she moves up, maybe inviting the rider from Ukraine to dive inside. She's not that keen to take the lead. In the old days, many years ago, you could stand on the side of your bike up on the track The world record stands at something like 10, 15 minutes.
Of a track stand, yeah.
Track stand.
Fascinating game of wills there as Chiluka drops right down. And now she's doing the watching, trying to anticipate when Hansen might have a go. Hansen just releases her hands and will gain. Be reluctant to go in front. Just out of the saddle a moment. Chiluka starts winding it up.
It's moving then counter move. Your reflexes have been, has to be cat-like to react to your opponent. Now Chaluka's got a bit of a opportunity here because Hansen has given her distance. The Ukraine rider knows it and she's got 15 metres on the Kiwi.
He's going to have to reel her in now with a powerful surge down the back, and she's done excellently here. Chiluka is working hard. Hansen is driving on the outside. Chiluka's holding on though. It's going to be tight. Here comes Hansen, but Chaluka's going to take it. Good race.
Excellent performance by Chiluka of Ukraine. Hansen thought she had got it right. Got the right tag, but in the end just didn't have the speed to get over the top of a rider that she was quicker than in qualifying. Matter of margins in the world of sprinting on the track. And indeed the road, when you look at the road finishes, it's about getting the right position, but the track is about to getting the tactics spot on. The time is not the thing that's impressive about Chiluka, the win is. So the losers will go through to the repechage, the winners progress. And there they are, Vogel, Schwang, Rodriguez, Panarina, Mears, Pendleton, Kupferschkaita, Lee and Chiluka.